Mark Kemmett, great to have you back. What does this mean?
I'm not sure what it means. It is clear that the situation on the ground is not one that promotes the use of peacekeepers. That's a very specific term. That's a Chapter 6 operation of the United Nations Charter. The idea there is once you have all sides in agreement, peacekeepers can come in to monitor the situation. It certainly is not the case that that's what's going on right now in northeastern Syria.
Do you think that this is maybe perhaps an admission by the United States that they do want to keep troops on the ground?
I think it is. I think it may have been an inartful use of the term peacekeepers. It's probably leaving 200 or so troops in there to help maintain the operational pace of the forces there and to ensure that Daesh or any other forces don't start fighting again. But that's a peace enforcement operation. That's a combat operation, not a peacekeeping mission.
So this announcement was made by the White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders shortly after a phone call between the U.S. President Donald Trump and the Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan, where they discussed the situation in Syria and they agreed to coordinating more and also on the creation of potential safe zones. They've been talking about that for a while, but it doesn't seem that anything has materialized. Where are they going with this?
Yet to be determined. I think the major sticking point would be the desire of Turkey to set up a buffer zone, a demilitarized zone that they would, in fact, keep troops inside of, say, 20 kilometers from the Turkish border to prevent terrorists from coming across and into Turkey. I think most people see safe zones as areas in which perhaps white helmets and other UN personnel could be monitoring the area, but the belligerent forces typically don't occupy a safe zone.
Turkey has vowed, of course, to remove the YPG from its borders, and they've been waiting for U.S. troops to leave in order to launch that operation. Could this have a potential impact on that, these 200 peacekeepers being in the country?
I don't think the 200 peacekeepers are going to make much of a difference. But I think that's why the Minister of Defense is here in Washington, D.C., to have these discussions with our Minister of Defense to figure out when we say a safe zone, what does that really mean? Who is it going to be safe for? Hopefully, it will rid itself of any terrorist organizations, but there's still some dispute in the United States on which organizations are, in fact, terror organizations that are occupying that area now.
All right, General Mark Kemmett, appreciate you being with us.